Are you looking to get hired on your next Cloud Architect interview? Well, in this video, I'm going to give you 5 Cloud Architect interview questions to help you show your stuff on your next Cloud Architect interview. The first question that I'm going to ask you is, how is block storage, object storage, and file storage used in cloud computing? And as a hiring manager, what I'm looking to hear is that block storage is a type of network storage that's used by virtual machines, and it can act like a hard drive to the virtual machine, even though it's network storage. And I'm looking for the person to know that object storage is typically used for backup and archival purposes, static website hosting. It's used to store static images and things. And file storage is typically used when multiple systems need to access the same information at the same time. For example, you have a file server and maybe 100 other servers need to access the same information over the network. And that's how block storage, object storage, and file storage is used in cloud computing. Another question I like to ask potential cloud architects is, how does a next generation firewall differ from a cloud native firewall such as an AWS WAF, which is made by the cloud provider? And when should you use each type of firewall? I'm looking for the cloud architect to know that a cloud provider's firewall like AWS WAF is a good firewall in general. It blocks unwanted traffic from coming in and allows outbound traffic to go out and then return. But a next generation firewall is adaptive in nature. So like a traditional firewall, it blocks all unwanted traffic from coming in and it allows internal traffic to go out. But should the system be hacked, a next generation firewall has included intrusion detection and intrusion prevention and will see the attack, and the firewall will dynamically try to mitigate the attack. So the key is, a next generation firewall provides much greater security, and that's going to be critical for big and enterprise organizations. But AWS WAF or a similar cloud native provider firewall is good for small things. So for a small business, AWS WAF might be perfect if they don't have great intellectual property or critical security needs. But a big business is going to need to use something like a next generation firewall. The next question I like to ask is, what would be a good type of a DNS policy to use for a BLUEGREEN deployment? And we're looking to see if people know anything about application deployment models as well as DNS. Now, the answer I'm typically looking for is weighted routing, because the key with a BLUEGREEN deployment, it's about a new application being deployed while still having the old one there. And I might want to send 90% of website traffic to the original application, for example, and 10% to the new one as a test. And weighted routing is the best way to support that BLUEGREEN application deployment model, where we point, say, 10% of the traffic to the new, 90% to the old application, and if everything works good in the test, we then divert all the traffic to the new application. Another question I like to ask potential cloud architects is, what is cloud computing? And here's the reason why. If someone tells me the certification answer of cloud computing is the on-demand delivery of compute, power, database storage, and applications, I'm generally going to ask another question and say, what does that mean to you? And 99% of the time, I'm not going to get an answer because the person doesn't know. But if someone says cloud computing is merely renting space in someone else's network and data center, so that data center has the same servers, the same storage, the same load balancers, but they're virtualizing and renting out a specific amount of space to it to me, I know they understand cloud computing and they can literally visualize what's going on in the service provider's data center. And if you're going to design a solution, I want to know that you know what's going on under the hood, so to speak. And therefore, that's pretty important to know from a cloud architect. I also like to ask people, what are some of the benefits of a private cloud compared to a public cloud? And I want people to know first what a private cloud is, but I also want them to be able to analyze and give me the analysis. I'm looking for an answer that includes the following. Enhanced security. See, with a private cloud, the organization has more control over its data and its infrastructure, which allows in a private cloud the organization to implement stricter security measures, customize security policies, and even compliance requirements. I'm also looking for the person to say increased control and customization. See, in a private cloud, you have much greater control over your resource allocation, your network configuration, your infrastructure management, and the organization in a private cloud can tailor everything to their needs. Performance optimization, hardware selection, and even software customization. I'm also looking for people to know that there's going to be better performance in a private cloud than there will be in a public cloud, because a private cloud is going to, generally speaking, offer higher network speeds, reduce latency, and the ability to prioritize one thing over another, which is going to ultimately give greater performance. I hope you learned some great cloud architect interview questions in this video. To learn how to become the ultimate cloud architect, or how to get your first cloud architect job, or how to get promoted in tech, please attend one of our free webinars. The link are in the description below. We also have a tremendous number of free resources to help you in your cloud architect career. We've placed those free resources in the description of this video. Lastly, please like this video and subscribe to this channel, and make sure to hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you in your cloud architect career.